Okay, now that you have all of your masks on, we're going to start to play with some layer adjustments. To do this, you need to get your adjustments palette open over here, and you can find that in the window drop-down menu, and then just make sure adjustments is checked off. You can really only learn these adjustments and what they do by playing with them. But what I'm going to teach you now is how to adjust and tweak just one individual part of your layer rather than the entire project. So if I were going to add a black and white layer adjustment onto my FJ Cruiser, which is this yellow guy right here, the first thing I need to do is select the part of the image that I want to adjust. So to do that, I'm going to use my quick selection tool and just paint in the part of the FJ that I want to adjust. So that's everything, right? All right, so there's my FJ Cruiser, and I've painted in all of the parts that I want to adjust. Now, before I add a black and white filter to this, I want to make sure I'm clicked on the image side of my layer, not my mask side. So make sure you're clicked on the image side of your layer. And I want to turn it black and white. Now, when I say turn things black and white, you don't have to. You can play with any of these other adjustments. But to make my FJ blend in with my black and white background, I'm going to convert it to a black and white photo itself. So I'm just going to click that that layer adjustment, and because I had my FJ selected, it automatically changed the yellow into that light gray color. Now that I have my giraffe and my FJ both grayed out, I'm going to keep my TARDIS blue, but you kind of lose it back there in the mist. So what I'm going to do is bump that blue up to make it even more noticeable. So again, just like I did for the FJ Cruiser, I'm going to select my TARDIS. So I'm going to use my quick selection tool, change my brush, maybe, wrong button. So we're going to change the brush here. And make a selection of the parts that you want to adjust. So in this case, it's all of my TARDIS. And then I'm just going to fix these nubbins. You want to try and get as close to your object as you can. It doesn't need to be absolutely 100% perfect, but it can be close, especially if you're working with such small objects like I am in regard to the TARDIS. Just bear with me. Yeah, we're going to switch this back so I can get this chunk back. All right, so now that we have my TARDIS selected, what I'm going to do is play with the color adjustments, and I'm going to bump that blue up. So I want to make sure I'm clicked on the TARDIS layer, and I'm going to add a hue and saturation filter. So you want to be clicked on the image side of your layer. Come back over to your layer adjustments palette, and I'm going to find hue and saturation. What that does is it really bumps up the color in your TARDIS. So you could make a TARDIS purple, blue, green, teal, however you want to. I'm going to keep it its traditional blue color, but I'm going to play with the saturation of it. That's how much blue is there. It can really make it pop, or it can really make it dull and blend into the background. And you can actually use this to turn things black and white. I'm just going to bump the blue up a little bit and then zoom back out. And that really made my TARDIS pop out a little bit more. So it's a little bit easier to see. Once you've added the layer adjustments to all of your images, go ahead and save your file, print it, make sure you go to the Google Classroom and turn in the assignment, and then you're all set. Great job.